Hey everyone, this is Emma Knightley, and we are back to Life is Strange. We just got proof that Dana is not in fact sexting Juliet's boyfriend, so we gotta show her that, and isn't high school a magical time for us all?
Juliet, probably. Read this. Of course.
Nimi shouldn't not believe your friends, so easily.
I'm an asshole. I'm sorry, Dana.
You are an asshole,
You
Juliet.
Are. And I hope so. You really think I'd mess around with Zachary?
No, but I get stupid jealous. I owe you dinner. Still love me?
And no. You do my laundry.
Thanks, Max. You're like the Blackwell Ninja. Now let's see what Zach has to say about Victoria.
You set me free. Thank you. Warren's flash drive is on my desk.
How did you know that I wanted that? I don't trust this girl. She's gonna murder. Oops.
Almost done. Get the flash drive, and then I'll go see Warren.
Let me talk to
her. Hey, Dana.
Quick.
Seriously, thanks again. I can't believe Juliet locked me in my own room.
I can't believe the door's locked
Real
from the
mature.
Outside. That's scary.
Poor Juliet gets her rage on. I hope she doesn't kill Victoria. Zachary should worry, too. As if I'd let that ego-case jockstrap touch me.
Ha.
But I bet Victoria would be all over that action. Or has been. Max, you're smart to be a loner here. Though Warren obviously likes hanging with you.
Not anymore. Apparently he wants space.
He's a good guy. A geek like me.
You saw the files in his flash drive. Tons of crazy shit. Films I've never even heard of. And in a special folder called Max.
Yeah, okay. I gotcha.
Are you blushing? Go ahead and grab the flash drive whenever.
Okay, I'm there, so I'm gonna go grab this and leave. And finally, the
Must
mission to get
precious, so Max never has to chase it down again.
Max is so real, though. Oh shit, Warren's probably like, I don't mind waiting out here forever. I love this parking lot. I can count all the cars. Okay, apparently he seems pretty funny. Oh my god. Okay, I'll go take a football photo. Is this the boyfriend, Zachary?
Fuck this shit.
Ow! That hurt!
Damn, I better rewind.
Okay.
Get lost, hipster. I'm not fuck this shit!
Ow!
Okay, what, do I have to get hit by it instead?
Fuck this shit!
Ow! That hurt!
Okay, no. I'm gonna get this right. I gotta block her. Oh, okay, apparently I can warn
Alyssa,
her.
Alyssa, move your head!
If you insist, Max.
Now that's what I'm talking about.
I don't
actually
even know this.
Somebody.
I'm glad I was gonna stop it with my entire being. Okay, let's see. Where's the photo? I can't believe Victoria texted me. It's probably like, hey, were you in my room, you fucker? And I'll be like, oh, yeah. By the way, thanks, but we're not friends. I'm glad that she wanted to establish that. More high school drama. Juliet wouldn't let Dana out of her room because she thought Zachary was sexting Dana. So stupid. I was so tired from everything, and since Dana borrowed Warren's flash drive, I had to intervene. Juliet told me Victoria was the one who gave her the inside scoop on Zach and Dana, so I knew that Victoria was playing them all. I snuck into Victoria's room and onto her laptop and found out that she was indeed lying through her ass just to create drama. Of course, I felt like a weasel going through Victoria's room and laptop. That's real. Once I gave Juliet the proof that Victoria was behind it all, I went to get Warren's flash drive from Dana. She was in a weird mood, but we said nasty things about Victoria, and I think it definitely made her feel better. We talked about Warren, and Dana implies he likes me. Ew. Gross. Boys, don't they know I only have eyes for my GF, my future GF, Chloe?
So don't think I'm blind.
Oh,
I
shit.
See everything here
it's
at Blackwell.
That fucker.
Do you understand what I'm saying?
No, and leave me alone.
I want to intervene.
Hey, why don't you leave her alone?
Don't
excuse
be
us. This is official campus business.
Excuse me, you shouldn't be yelling at students or bullying them.
Hey, hey, nobody is bullying anybody. I'm doing my job.
No, you're
Where
not.
Are all the adults
you're
in this
part of the problem, Missy.
Assholes.
I will remember this conversation.
I bet you will.
Oh, Max, that was great. I think you scared him for once. I have to go, but thank you. It means a lot.
Anytime, Kate.
See, I would have felt like shit just leaving her to be bullied while I didn't take a photo.
I felt like an everyday hero helping Kate, but now Officer David Dickhead is after me.
If it wasn't one thing, it should be another. I'll never mind my own business, though. That ain't me, man. I did it. I did the mission. Aw, yeah.
I'm glad I stepped in that time. Can't stand to see people being bullied.
Juliet.
I don't get it. How could Zack and Victoria do that to
when
me?
When we made love,
Hi,
he
Juliet.
Used to cry.
How are you doing?
Oh, hey, Max. Sorry. I'm still screwed up.
Sorry you had to find out about Zachary that way. Or anyway.
Better sooner than later. Now that skank Victoria won't be laughing behind my back anymore.
So have you talked to Zach yet?
Mr. Badass Football Hero is such a chicken shit. He said he sexted Victoria as a
Yeah, it was super funny.
Ha ha. I think Warren wants your attention.
He's like, oh, no, this is really
he
funny.
Usually
My dick is out because this is so funny.
Hang in there, Juliet.
See you around, Max.
Warren's like, I've been waiting for 10 hours. So you go talk to that girl first.
Max, get your ass over here.
Oh. Look. I'm going to look at him. Appreciate.
And there's Warren. Did he actually buy a used car? Look at Warren and his Wayback Machine.
Yo, Max, check it out.
He's a brave man.
What up, Max? How are you?
Here's your flash. Thanks.
Oh.
No problem. Check out my new wheels.
Whoops.
Cool. Very old school.
1978, to be exact. Now we can go to the drive-in. There's one in Newburgh just 60 miles away.
You're in the wrong time.
A drive-in.
Then
I don't trust
us. So
you okay?
It's been one strange fucking day.
I bet. I heard Victoria got a face full of paint. I'd pay money to see a photo of that.
Really? I wish I would have known.
You probably could have raised a Kickstarter fund just for that one image of her covered in paint.
Does he know what
Had
Kickstarter?
I known that. Anyway, Victoria took down my photo, so that drama ended well.
By the way, I saw Daniel's sketch of you online. Not bad, but I could do a much better job.
He's like, yeah, while I was fucking waiting.
You can draw? I thought you were blinded by science, not art.
Oh, you, Max.
Art is science. Music is math, etc., etc. I'd put Stephen Hawking against Picasso any day.
Hardcore. So you must use a computer to draw?
Of course. I'd love to tweak one of your selfies with some cool graphics.
That might not suck.
Gonna
I'll
put
you know.
Some, like, stamps on it.
So, did you get
it?
A chance to check out the movie booty on my flash drive?
I watched all of Fullmetal Alchemist.
You had some cool shit on there, from Akira to Twilight Zone, which seems apropos today.
I consider myself a pop cultural pirate connoisseur.
That does sound better than thief.
Ha ha. Make sure you watch Cannibal Holocaust.
Seen it. I was more disturbed by all those emo vampire movies in there.
Can a sensitive high school boy love sensitive vampires too?
He's a vampire. I'm calling it. This is my game theory.
Ouch,
he's a vampire.
That sounds awful the way you say it.
No, I was impressed you had faster pussycat kill.
Russ Mayer was a genius of black and white. Plus, babes with breasts.
Who would beat your sensitive ass down?
If I was lucky. Speaking of hip and fast, we should cruise out in my car to an actual movie this week. But you seem distracted.
Yeah, I can turn back time.
To talk to somebody. Just to get it out of my system.
Dr. Warren Graham is in the house. I won't even prescribe you any meds.
This guy is like endearingly just kind of...
For reals, Warren. This is ridiculous. Between you and me, not social media.
Don't insult me. Max, go on.
I had this incredibly bizarro experience in Mr. Jefferson's class today. I mean, life-changing. Have you ever had a dream so real it was like a movie?
Max Caulfield,
dreams are
right?
More real than...
You're one of the Jefferson's photo groupies?
No.
I'm one of his students.
What the fuck ever? I know you like to take pictures, especially when you're hiding out in the bathrooms.
No.
You best tell me what you told the principal, now.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Answer me, bitch!
Fuck. Okay, I can rewind.
I told him the truth. A student had a gun.
No, you told him I had a gun. That's why he dragged me into his office.
Well, I mean, you were the student.
And did what, give you a stern lecture?
Nobody lectures me. Everyone tries, though. They try.
This guy is not okay.
You should talk to somebody, Nathan.
Do not analyze me!
Max.
I pay people for that. Worry about yourself, Max Caulfield.
Take a step
back,
Nathan Prescott.
Oh, man. You're telling me what to do?
Get away from her, dude!
Oh, shit!
Hey! Leave him alone!
Nobody tells me what to do! Not my parents, not the principal,
that.
Or that whore in the bathroom!
Ah! Ah! Save me, Edward Cullen!
Max? Chloe?
No way. You again.
Warren.
Go! I got this!
Oh, shit!
Stay in, Max!
Oh, okay, we're escaping?
Get your punk asses!
Okay.
Get in there now! Don't even try to run! Nobody! Nobody!
Oh my god! That was most ridiculous. I can't believe we had to, like, vehicle run away from this...
Nathan Prescott is
punk-ass high schooler.
And dangerous.
He is very scary, though.
This day never ends.
Oh, and thanks, Chloe. After 5 years, you're still Max Caulfield.
Oh, well, I'm sorry. I had more pressing things happening.
Don't give me the guilty face. At least pretend you're glad to see me.
I am seriously glad to see you. Oh, and thanks, Chloe. It makes perfect sense I'd see you today.
Yes, it's been that kind of day. So what did that freak want with you?
Hopefully nothing after today. So, how do you know Nathan?
He's just another Arcadia asshole. Your friend really took a beat down for you.
Warren? Yeah, I owe him big time.
Warren's dead
you're
for
not
the
only
rest
one
of the game.
And you're already causing trouble.
I thought it would be quiet here. Feels so weird to be back.
So I guess Seattle sucked hard?
I guess.
It was cool, but I felt kind of lonely, out of my league.
I would think you'd fit right in with the art school hipsters.
I'm so sad I'm finally being the GF.
You look like the cover of hipstergirl.com.
At least you're still a smartass.
That's why I'm here.
Please, girl. You came back for Blackwell Academy.
Only for Mark Jefferson? No.
Of course. It's one of the best photography programs in the country. And my favorite teacher, Mark Jefferson.
So you came back to Arcadia for a teacher, not your best
fuck.
Friend.
Don't you think I'm happy to see you?
You don't look happy.
You were happy to wait 5 years without a call or even a text.
I wanted to. I was just so tripped out over leaving Arcadia.
Oh, please. I'm sure your phone and laptop were frozen in time.
It's
you're
true.
Merciless.
You've been at Blackwell for almost a month without letting me know. Enough said.
I just wanted to settle in first and not be such a shy, cliche geek. I totally would have contacted you.
I bet you don't use these sad excuses on Mr. Jefferson. Don't use them on me, Max.
Man, Chloe is hardcore. She's telling how it is. Max doesn't even have anything to say about it, which is understandable. Take a picture of her. Yes! What? Why is it broken?
Man, are you serial?
Wow, haven't heard that one in a while.
Yeah.
Not everything changes. Except my camera has officially taken a shit.
My step douche has a boatload of tools. Maybe you can fix it in my place.
I need very specific tiny tools.
Bird alert. My stepdad has a fully stocked garage, and he actually is a tiny tool.
Oh, good one. Good one, Chloe. I like these cute high schoolers that are so high school-y. My stepdad's a tool. Are you cereal? I love it. I guess Chloe's is in the Red Room room, since apparently she lives at home.
Come on in, don't be shy. The house still looks nice.
Home, shit, home.
Oh, yep, high schooler. Oh, no, come back. Whoa, okay, so... That's subtle. I see this subtle foreshadowing.
My room looks a bit different than the last time you saw it.
It's cool. At least we can chill out.
This isn't exactly my chill-out zone. My step-fuhrer makes sure of that. Come in and close the door. Put on some music while I medicate.
I wish she's drawn all of this. You know, my sisters did this, like, when they were, like, in early high school. They just, like, drew all over the walls and doors and stuff.
It won't play without any power.
Oh, okay. Well, search.
Look at that. Chloe and her dad were so close.
Now he's dead. That cat's dead too.
I'm not into them. Too pretentious.
Ooh.
Damn, Chloe does need a lot of money to get out of Arcadia.
Power strip. Switch on. Everything explodes. Game over. Aw, I love Christmas lights.
Now, let's see what kind of music Chloe is into these days.
Okay. God, what does she want me to do? I have to find music to put on. Oh. I'm starting to get the hang of this whole rewind thing. I don't want to waste this power, but there has to be a reason it was given to me, so I better learn how to use it right. I started by saving Alyssa from being a football field headshot. I admit it felt amazing just to help Alyssa with something as simple as that. I also saw David Madsen hassling Kate Marsh. I couldn't hear everything, but he was accusing her of something. All that guy can do is point fingers. I got so pissed I went over to stop him from being such a bully. He's a security guard, not a stormtrooper. He was an asshole, as usual, but I felt good about what I did, and Kate seemed truly happy that someone stood up for her. And I did that without using a rewind power. This day just keeps getting stranger. I don't even believe what I'm writing, and I can't even do a simple task of giving Warren back his flash drive without getting into a situation. In this case, though, it turned out half bad, half good, which I guess is the yin and yang of life. When I met with Warren in the lot and checked out his new retro wheels, guess who showed up? Nathan Prescott, freaking out all over again. He got all up in my face, accused me of bullshit. Even though I was scared because I knew what he did to that girl in the bathroom, I was more furious. Then the girl in the bathroom pulled up in a truck, my former best friend, Chloe Price. We both looked at each other like, WTF. Next thing I knew, I was in her truck as Warren earned his man card. Oh, fuck. And tried to get Nathan off my ass. Man, I hate that. I owe Warren big time. Seeing Chloe for the first time in 5 years was such a shock I was almost paralyzed, especially after realizing that Nathan had almost killed her right in front of me. Now Chloe shows up out of the blue to save me. Of all the bizarre and unexplainable shit happening today, seeing Chloe's battered truck, listening to music, and staring at her dashboard bobblehead might be at the top. So I tried to process the fact that Chloe and I were two best friends who didn't know each other anymore. She had blue hair, piercings, and cool boots, and I looked like a dork. I didn't know where to start, and she wasn't exactly extending an olive branch. So we sat like strangers. At least I had time to catch my breath and realize that in the parking lot melee with Nathan and Warren, my camera got busted up. I didn't care considering everything else going on, but it sucked on top of everything else going on. Warren! I knew if I gave Warren my phone, he would blow it up for science. He wants his flash drive back after letting me borrow it for less than a week. He told me to watch everything because he has tons of cool TV shows and films on there. Thank God it wasn't porn. And I am thankful for Warren. He's a real friend and we share a lot of the same interests. He loves science, but he really understands art and appreciates great photography. Even though he says he loves my pictures, I can't tell if he's just being nice. Warren is a geek, but he definitely lets you know where he stands. I don't think he would ever lie to me. It feels good to have at least one strong ally the same age here. And he makes me smile. Well, isn't that cute? But here's my GF, Chloe. Then there's Chloe Price. What do you say to your best friend after 5 years of silence? After finding out you saved her life in a bathroom? nothing. I feel so lame for not staying in touch, or even text. I have no idea how to process seeing Chloe like this again. For one thing, she looks so similar, but so different. She's all grown up now, but it doesn't seem like she's only 1 year yet older than me. I absolutely love her blue hair and punk clothes. It makes sense she would become a rebel. She still kind of looks like a pirate, except one who stage dives. I know she's angry with me because of her body language. I'm glad I can still see the old Chloe in there. Or is that the young Chloe? I'm sure she's still messed up about her dad dying. He's dead. I would be too. That was a terrible time for Chloe and Joyce. I feel bad because I wonder if I was happy to move away just to avoid the grief. Speaking of grief, it's clear she's all mixed up with Nathan Prescott's shit. I have no idea what's going on between them, but I'm going to find out, no matter what. Cool. Okay. I gotta search for the tunes.
I think this junk swallowed her discs.
So you use your laptop.
She looks super happy.
Oh, she's so cute.
She looks super sad. She looks super stoned.
Good. I'm so glad. I'm gonna search this for it. Do you have any music in here?
Who'd have thunk Chloe wouldn't pay her parking tickets? She does love trouble.
Just searches all her stuff right in front of her, like it's no big deal. Oh, is that her when she's a little baby? Oh shit! It's her and
hey,
what's her face?
Hey, give me that. Sorry, I wasn't trying to be nosy.
I hope that they were girlfriends.
She was a good friend.
It's putting it mildly.
Oh shit! They were girlfriends. I'm calling it.
That's Rachel Amber. Her missing person
is she your
posters
girlfriend?
Are all over Blackwell.
Or was she your girlfriend?
Yeah, I put them up. She was my angel.
Oh.
After my dad died and you moved, I felt abandoned. Rachel saved my life.
Rachel.
Man, I had no idea.
Laura Palmer,
well,
we all love her.
I never made much effort to find out. I was 14. We were best friends.
I never forgot. Even if I was an asshole and didn't keep in touch. But you had Rachel.
Rachel had my back. We were gonna kick the world's ass. You would laugh at how different we were. She wanted to be a star.
She looks like a model.
That was her plan. Our plan. Get the hell out of Bigfootville and into Los Angeles.
So what happened? Did your folks, your mom, try to stop you?
My mom was too busy hooked up with Sergeant Shithead.
I feel the love.
She hates him so
much.
When
did Rachel actually disappear?
6 months ago. She just left Arcadia. Without a word. Without me.
Chloe, I have news for you. She's dead.
How do you know she disappeared? Maybe she wanted to start a totally new life.
Unlike you, she would have told me, okay?
Oh,
something
shit.
Happened to her.
Chloe's cast
you.
In shade.
I'm just trying to get all deductive.
Before Rachel left, she said she met somebody who changed her life. And poof.
And you haven't heard anything from her since?
Like everybody in my life. My dad, you, and Rachel. Gone. Can you put on some music now?
Okay. I can do that. Sad lesbians, the game. That's my understanding of this game right now. The only thing I know about this is the characters and that people say that they're in love. So that's all I'm going off of, actually, basically.
Anyway, you can find tools to fix your camera in the garage.
Chloe, are you okay?
Sure,
not.
I'm awesome. I just want to blaze and be alone for a moment.
Okay, I'll go wander around your thing by myself. It definitely won't be super weird. I'll just rifle through your...
We had such a blast drawing these together.
Oh, that's so cute. That's super cute. I'm so sad that she had that, and
this postcard is from Rachel Amber.
Did not keep in touch with her at all.
Mm-hmm.
Max, why didn't you keep in touch with Chloe? Well, I guess I kind of explained that, because I said she was probably, like, it was a lot for her to deal with, but I'm still like, Max, what the fuck?
Whoa, dark. I cannot see anything.
Okay, turn on the switch, and then look.
This is definitely Joyce's makeup. Chloe wouldn't use animal products.
It's very Seattle-in. Or I guess Washington.
I hope Chloe isn't taking these pills.
I'm just gonna look at all this stuff.
I
they
like
can't
Chloe's
stop
new
me.
Hair color. She's the opposite of shy. Of me.
Picture.
You can't go home again, said Thomas Wolfe. But here I am.
Fuck you, Thomas Wolfe. You don't know my life. Okay. So, this seems like a good place to call it. Next episode, we will go downstairs and fix my camera, and things will probably go smoothly, not mess up at all. Have a great day, everyone. This has been Emmy Nightly with Life is Strange.